Mary Maloney put down her sewing and glanced at the clock.
4:30.
She wasn't anxious at all, merely glad to think that her husband would soon be home. When it got to nearly 5, she started to listen, and sure enough, she was soon rewarded with the sound of his car on the gravel outside and his key in the lock.
Patrick, I'm in the living room.
Hello, honey.
Don't I get a kiss?
Oh, sorry.
Oh, you look tired, darling. Hang your coat in the closet and I'll fix you a drink.
For Mary, this was always a blissful time of day. Patrick rarely said much before the first drink was finished, but she was happy just to have him near her, exulting in his presence after hours alone in the house.
Aren't you having one?
No, best not. You know what the doctor says. We have to take care of our precious little gift. I felt him kicking again today.
Yeah? Maybe he'll play for the Giants when he grows up, huh? Oh,
you drank that quick? Shall I get you another?
Sit down. I'll get it.
Oh, poor Patrick. They work you too hard down at that precinct. It isn't fair. You're a senior policeman now, but you did fewer hours when you were pounding the beat.
Patrick didn't reply, and Mary found herself thinking back to his days as a beat cop. He'd still been in uniform when she'd first met him. October 4, 1951. She could still remember the exact day, even though it was over 3 years ago. New to the city, she'd got lost downtown, and Patrick, smart and strong and handsome, had shown her home.
Do you want some cheese with that? I haven't made supper because it's Thursday.
No, I'm all right.
No, if you're too tired to eat out, it's not too late. There's plenty of meat and stuff in the freezer.
No, I told you, I'm not hungry.
Of course, we don't have any fresh vegetables, but Sam will still be open. We can have lamb chops or pork, anything you want. It's all in the freezer.
Mary, will you please sit down? I've got something to tell you.
Well, what is it, darling? What's the matter?
This is going to be a bit of a shock, I'm afraid. But I've given it some thought, and I've decided that telling you is the only way. I just hope that when I'm done, you won't blame me too much.
And he told her. Mary sat very still through it all, watching him with a kind of dazed horror as he went further and further away from her with each word.
So there it is. Now, I know it's kind of a bad time with a baby on the way and everything, but you'll both be provided for, so there shouldn't be no need for any fuss. That would not be good for my job, Mary. Well, say something.
I'll get the supper.
Mary couldn't feel her legs as she descended the steps to the cellar. She couldn't feel anything at all, except a slight nausea. Her movements were entirely automatic as she opened the freezer, put her hand inside and took out the first object it met. A leg of lamb.
What?
A leg of lamb. I thought we'd have lamb for supper.
Patrick was standing at the window. He didn't even turn to look at her as he spoke.
I already said I'm not hungry.
But you gotta have something to eat.
Put it back in the freezer. I'm going out.
At that point, Mary simply walked up behind him, swung the big frozen leg of lamb high above his head, and she stepped back a pace, waiting. For at least 4 or 5 seconds, he just stood there, gently swaying. The violence of the crash, the noise, the small table overturning brought her out of her shock. She might just as well have hit him with a steel club.
All right. All right. So I've killed him.
It was extraordinary how clear her mind became all of a sudden. She was a detective's wife, so she knew the consequences of what she'd just done. She didn't care. In fact, it would be a relief. But what about the baby?
Will they kill us both together? Or will they wait until the 10th month?
Mary didn't know. And she had no intention of finding out. Still holding it by the thin bone end, Mary carried the meat into the kitchen, turned on the oven, and shoved it inside. She washed her hands, ran upstairs, and sat down at her dressing table. She tried smiling at herself in the mirror. It looked peculiar.
Good evening, Sam.
Her voice sounded peculiar, too.
Good evening, Sam. I'd like some potatoes, please, and a can of peas.
That was it. Much more convincing. She looked over at the clock next to her bed. Good. It was still only 5:45.
Good evening, Sam.
Why, good evening to you, Mrs. Maloney. How are you?
I'd like some potatoes, please, and a can of peas.
Now, I thought you and Patrick always ate out on a Thursday.
Oh, he's too tired, so I'm cooking him roast lamb. I found a nice piece in the freezer.
Ah.
I don't really like cooking it from frozen. Do you think it'll be all right, Sam?
Now, personally, I don't see as it makes any difference. And you want these Idaho potatoes?
Oh, that'll be fine. I'll take two.
And, now what about for afterwards? Or what are you going to give him for afterwards?
Well, what would you suggest?
How about a nice slice of cheesecake? Does Patrick like cheesecake?
Perfect. He loves it.
Act naturally. That's what she told herself. She was just a New York housewife returning home from the store, not expecting to find anything unusual or tragic or terrible.
Patrick! I'm back! Patrick?
Act naturally, and everyone would believe her.
Oh, Patrick!
When she saw him lying there with his legs doubled up and an arm twisted back beneath his body, it almost came as a genuine shock. Suddenly, all the old love and longing for him welled up inside her, and she knelt down beside him and cried her heart out. When at last she'd finished weeping, she got up, reached for the telephone, and called the police.
Mary, for the love of God, what happened?
He's dead, Jack. Somebody's killed him.
Mary knew the two men from homicide. They were colleagues of Patrick's. She was glad they'd sent her people she knew.
Yeah, there's a small wound to the back of the head, Sergeant Noonan, but not much blood, though.
All right, better leave it for the doctor, O'Malley. He's on his way.
Why, Patrick? Why him?
It's all right. It's all right, Mary. We're here now. Come on.
That's probably the photographer and the fingerprint boys.
Come on, Mary. Come on. Let's leave him to work. Come on through to the kitchen and sit down, huh? Here. Have a glass of water. That's it. How you feeling?
A little better, thanks.
Only, I need to ask you some questions. Now, if you'd rather I wait...
No, honestly, Jack, I'm fine.
All right, all right. Tell me about this evening. What time did Patrick get home?
A little after 5. He's always very punctual. Was always very punctual.
Do you need a moment?
No. No, I'm okay. It's just all been such a shock.
I know. All right, now, how did he seem? Did he say if anything was bothering him?
Well, he didn't say much at all. Tired, I guess. It's such hard work down at the precinct.
Tell me about it.
We normally eat out on a Thursday, but with Patrick not being in the mood and everything, we decided to have supper at home. I took a leg of lamb out of the freezer and put it in the oven. Oh, that's it, cooking over there.
Oh, you can't beat a nice leg of lamb.
We didn't have any vegetables in the house, so I went to the store to buy some. And when I got back... Well, you know what I found.
Yeah, it all checks out. She got to the store about 6. The grocer says she seemed happy, cheerful even. She told him she wanted to give Patrick a good supper and bought some potatoes, a can of peas, and, a big slice of cheesecake.
Oh, for Pete's sake, O'Malley, I don't need the contents of a shopping bag.
You're just being thorough, Jack.
Yeah, I know. It's this case. It's driving me nuts. An hour we've been here. What do we got? Bupkis.
Yeah, any fingerprints?
Just hers and Patrick's. No sign of a forced entry either. It don't make sense.
Well, what about the cause of death? Do we know what killed him?
A single blow to the back of the head. Done with a heavy, blunt instrument, according to the doctor. It's probably something metal.
The house had been busy for the last hour, but slowly it started to empty out. The police surgeon had already gone. The photographer went next. Then the experts on fingerprints. Okay, finally, two men came in and lifted Patrick's body onto the stretcher.
What are you doing?
Mary, I thought I told you to stay in the kitchen.
You can't take him. You can't.
Stop it, Mary. You gotta let them do their job.
Carry on, boys.
I'm sorry, Jack. I'm so sorry. It's just...
Yeah, it's all right. I understand. But I don't think you should stay here tonight. Now, haven't you got a sister up in Queens... Or what about my wife? You know my wife.
Honestly, Jack, I couldn't.
All right. At least go and lie down on your bed for a while.
I'd rather just sit in that armchair if you don't mind.
I'm not feeling too good. Maybe later.
If that's what you want. But we'll have to search the house again. We need to find the murder weapon.
Oh?
He could have taken it with him, of course, but it's more likely he dropped it here.
Yeah, look around the room, Mrs. Maloney. Can you tell if anything's missing?
Like what?
I don't know. Like maybe a metal vase?
We don't have a metal vase.
All right, what about a big wrench? Do you have one of those?
I don't think so. Maybe in the garage?
All right, check it out, O'Malley.
Yeah, I'm on it.
Whatever he used, we'll find it. And when we do, well, it's the old story. Get the weapon, and you got the man.
The search went on. Other policemen arrived and started to hunt round in the garden. Mary could hear their footsteps outside on the gravel, and occasionally she saw flashlights through a chink in the curtains. It began to get late, 9 o'clock. The men conducting the search seemed to be growing weary and a trifle exasperated. The next time Sergeant Noonan went past, Mary called him in.
Jack, would you mind getting me a drink?
Sure, I'll get you a drink. Whiskey?
A small one, please. And have one yourself.
I shouldn't really.
Please, Jack. You've been so kind to me, and you must be tired.
Oh, just a drop, then, to keep me going.
Yeah, we finished in the kitchen. Nothing.
Well, search it again.
All right, but I don't think we'll find anything. Oh, and, Mrs. Maloney?
Yeah?
That oven of yours is still on, and the meat's still inside.
Oh, no. I forgot about it.
Well, should I turn it off?
Turn it off?
Is everything all right, Mary?
I was wondering, Jack, would you and the other men do me a small favor?
We can try.
You've all been working so hard trying to catch poor Patrick's killer, and I know it's long past your supper time. The meat in the oven will be cooked by now. Would you do me a favor by eating it up?
Oh, we wouldn't dream of it, would we, O'Malley?
Well...
Please, Jack. Patrick, God bless his soul, would never forgive me if I didn't look after you properly. Have something to eat. You deserve it. Then you can get on with your work.
Have some more?
Better not finish it.
Yeah, she wants us to finish it. That's what she said. No, I'll cut you another piece.
Oh, all right. You know, that must have been a hell of a club the guy used on Patrick. The doc says his skull was all smashed to pieces.
Yeah, it ought to be easy to find, then.
Exactly. Mm. Whoever did it isn't going to be carrying a thing like that around any longer than he needs.
Uh-huh.
You know, personally, I think it's still here on the premises.
Me too. Mm. Yeah, it's probably right under our very noses.
And listening in the other room, Mary started to giggle.